So first I will start with the vectors. Okay, you are able to see my screen?
Yeah, I'm able to see this.
Okay, so in general, first I'm explaining. Okay, so vectors means vector will have the magnitude. Okay, magnitude means what the other name is size. It will have the size. Okay, and direction also it will have. Okay, it will have the size and also the direction. Okay. Right. This is already taught in your class, or this is the first time you are studying about this, Deepika?
I've learned about some parts of a topic already.
Ah, okay. That is addition, all those things, basic things you have there, read, right? Okay. See, direction means I'm talking about this one. So, which direction it will go? It will go to the north or south. Okay. So, if suppose I'm going to have an arrow like this, okay. Fine. This is the direction. Okay. This path you call it to be the direction where it is going. Okay. And from here, this thicker line shows you the magnitude. Okay. You got it. So this is called as a magnitude. Fine. So here, if I'm going to have two vectors, I'm going to simply. Okay. I'm going to have two vectors. So vectors are nothing but it is going to have the magnitude and direction. Suppose A is one of the vector and B is one of the vector. Then you can say that you can just join the head and tail to make A plus B. Okay. Fine. Got it, Deepika? And the order is not important here. You can also say that it is B plus A. That's not a big deal. You will get the same answer. Okay. Fine. You understand the concept? Yes. So the same thing you will, hello, Deepika, can you hear me?
Yes.
Ha, okay, fine. Same thing you will be following for your subtraction also. This is for the addition I told you, okay? So there, what will happen is, if suppose this is my A, I'm drawing randomly, okay? This is my A, okay? And this is my B, okay? Fine. Now, your subtraction means the negative direction will be this side, okay? The opposite of B. Fine. Then this will give you A minus B. Okay. You understand? Fine. So vector, you often written it in bold letters. Okay. For example, like thickened letters you will be using. Very thick letters. Okay. Fine. And you can take any alphabet there. Okay. Fine. And you will put a vector symbol at the top. Okay, you understand, Deepika? Now, if they are going to ask you to add a vector, okay, so for example, if they are going to give you, first I will complete for the introduction of the vectors, then I'll go for the scalars, okay? So, suppose if they are giving, like we have to calculate it for, there is a triangle like this, okay? This is 8, this I will take it as 13, okay? Fine. And one more side length I will have, which will be having like this, I will assume. Okay. Fine. Now, this is 7 and this is, okay, I will have some 26 or something. Okay. So the vectors here are 8, 13 and it would be 26, 7. Okay. Now, if they are asking us to add these vectors, okay, this is A, this is B. Okay. So what is the formula? It is AC equals to A plus B. Okay, fine. So you need to add up this with this, the first coordinate with the first and second with this. Okay, fine. So it would be nothing but 8 plus 26, 13 plus 7. Okay, understood, Deepika? Got it?
Yes.
Okay, so coming to the scalars, if I'm going to talk about the scalars, okay, so I told you for vectors, it is nothing but the both the magnitude and direction. Whereas for the scalar, we will have only the magnitude, that is the size. Okay? Got it? So we will be there along only with the size of the given thing. Okay? Fine? So for example, scalars means I can have, I will split the board into two. So, scalar is like a single number, okay? We usually use this for dealing with, when we are dealing with your vectors or matrices, Okay, so if I suppose, for example, if I want to multiply a vector, say comma 5, 2, okay, by a scalar 3, a number, scalar is nothing but a 3, that means a magnitude. Okay, so only the size of that will be given, you don't have the direction for that. Okay, this case only we will be using the scalar. Okay, fine. So I have a PowerPoint for you, just I will share that, just a minute. One second. Can you see my screen?
Yes.
Okay. So, see this. So I'm going to show you the examples of the scalar quantities, okay, which you are measuring with numbers and units. The inch tape, okay, the thermometer or the clock, that is the timer, whatever you are using for the lab at all those things are like, so this is, see this, the length, here it is 16 centimeters. So here we are talking about the weight of the particular object, no direction is there, right? Similarly, the temperature, the time, all those things are the examples of scalar quantity. Okay, now what is a vector? It is measured with numbers and also units, but will have a specific direction. For example, you can take the rocket, so acceleration here. Okay, fine. So here you will have, you will say that the acceleration, that is the motion of the object, will be 30 meter per second square. It's moving, and it is moving what direction? It is moving upward. Okay, and also the map, whatever it is, if you are going to travel through a ship or something, the displacement is 200 miles north. Okay, fine. And next, the force. Force of the object where, suppose an apple, here they are showing an apple or something. Okay, you can remember the Newton's law. Okay, so the Newton was sitting under a tree, the apple is coming and hitting under the head. All those things, that's force. Okay, so there it is coming from the top to bottom. So downward, that is the direction. Okay, fine. Next, coming to the distance or displacement. Okay, distance will be a scalar quantity. Okay, whereas displacement will be a vector quantity. Why distance is a scalar quantity? Because distance means, I will say 5 kilometer, 4 kilometer. Okay, displacement means you will say along from one place you have shifted to another place, right? Okay, so there you will have the direction also along with that. Okay, fine. You understand, Deepika?
Yeah.
Okay. Next, what about these things we will be using in the problem? So they are just giving the definition, basic definitions for you. Okay, speed. What is the speed? It's a rate of change of distance in the direction of the travel. Okay, fine. Rate of change is nothing but like a slope. Okay, so if I wanted to calculate average speed, it is nothing but distance divided by time. Okay, and average velocity means it is displacement divided by the time. Okay. Fine. So speed is nothing but distance over time. Velocity is displacement over time. Okay. Next. So you can take some things. Okay. I will just show you for the adding your vectors. Okay. How you will add the vectors. Okay. So displacement is nothing but it is independent of the route taken between start and the end point. So it there is no what I will say conditions of that you have to follow this direction or that direction. From the start to end point, the movement, you call it to be the displacement. Okay, for example, if a car moves from A to B then to C, total displacement will be the same as if we had just moved in a straight line from A to C. Okay, fine. Deepika, you cannot change the things. Okay. And it's the direction of the driver who is making the thing. Okay. So two or more displacement vectors, you can add it from nose to tail. Okay. To calculate your resultant vectors from the starting point to the end point. Okay. So any two vectors of the same type, you can add it in this way to find your resultant. That's what I showed you. A plus B. If A is one vector, B is one vector, you can add up and show A plus B. Okay. Fine. Okay. Next is your simplifying your vectors. Okay. So if I'm going to add it up, okay, so it is always for, obviously we can simplify the vectors. Okay. Fine. So this is the x component you just assume. This is a y component you're assuming. So its displacement will be the same, but it is now how much easier to describe it. So describing means, see how they are described. Car has a final displacement of x miles, okay, and y miles not. East it is x miles and y miles not. So you can represent just x and y. Simplifying and writing in the vectors is also possible, that you represent it in terms of races. Okay, got it?
Yeah.
Okay. Similarly, what is the missing from each vector equation? So you are adding this, right? So what will happen here? It is, they have given the option also for this. I think this won't work. Okay. So 3 minus 3 you will do. So 3 minus of minus 3, that is okay. 3 plus 3 we have to do. There is something wrong here. 2 plus 2 is 4. That's fine. Ha, yes. 0 comma 4. The option is here. Okay, first vector, first component with the first component. So 3 minus 3 is 0. Okay, 2 plus 2 will be 4. Okay, Deepika, got it?
Yeah.
So this is a small introduction. Just a second. I need to click it out. Okay. Oh, screen sharing is stopped. I wanted to show one more. Yes. Okay, this has some problems. Okay, 1 minute. You okay? I'm sharing a screen. Just tell me, is this your, because it's showing Singapore textbook only. I'm just sharing my screen. Just a second. Just see, you are able to see my screen?
Yes, I'm able.
Okay. This kind of problems are there for you. It is showing Singapore math only.
Yeah.
You have
a cross product.
Cross and dot product, right? Okay.
Yeah.
Just a second. Let me come down. If it is there here, otherwise I will teach my own. Okay. Difference between two. Multiplying cross and dot product. I hope it should be there. This is unit vectors. Yes. Here it is, dot product. Okay. So dot product is a method where you are going to multiply two vectors. Okay. So if I'm going to multiply, okay, so product of a multiplication will be a scalar. Obviously, if I'm going to multiply a vector, vector is like numbers only. Two numbers, if you multiply, you will get a constant number only there. That becomes a scalar only, right? So dot product is sometimes referred to as the scalar product. Another name of your dot product, you call it to be the scalar product, because if you use the dot product, that is a multiplication, if you do you multiply two vectors, you are going to get a scalar answer. So that's why dot product, another name you call it to be scalar product. Okay, so where we will be using this dot product to find an angle between two vectors, and any problem which is related with distance between two points and lines, points and planes, etc. Okay, so for example, if u is nothing but u1 comma u2, v is nothing but v1 comma v2. There is a vector there, you are going to find the dot product. How we are going to do u dot v? That means the first component with this, okay, you got it, u1 v1 plus u2 v2. Okay, Deepika, got it? If suppose I'm going to have three components, what you have to do? u1 v1 plus u2 v2 plus u3 v3. Okay, you understand? So each and everything, the first component with the first component, you have to multiply, plus second component with the second component, plus third component with the third component. Okay. Now, for example, they have given this. What I'm going to do? This is u1, u2, u3. Okay. v1, v2, v3. So what you will do? u1, v1. So it is 1 comma 1 times 4 plus u2 v2, so that would be 2 times 5 plus 3 times 6, because it's u3 v3. We are just adding it. Okay, you understood? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, shall I give a problem in this model? One model we will try, and then we will go to the next step. Okay, suppose it's 2 3 4, and your v is going to be -1 3 4 sorry 5 every day. Positive one, it's a failed day, because yeah, Can you tell me what will be the dot product for this?
Which one?
I have given the question here. You have given, we have given, just find the dot product for the center. U dot V.
31.
How much are you getting?
31.
Yes. Okay, good. So, these are the properties we will be using in the dot product. Okay. So, if I am going to have an, they are asking us to find the absolute value of U. That you can write it as square root of U times U. How they are taking, you know what is your U, that is U1 comma U2, okay? If I'm going, absolute value of U means, it's like you have to multiply U two times, am I right? So that means U1, U2 comma, dot product of U1 comma U2. So that means what you will multiply this with this, that will become U1 square. How is the dot product you will do? The first component with the first component there, okay? So second component with the second component, that will become U2 square. Okay, so this becomes U1 square plus U2 square, which you can write it as absolute value of U the whole square. Okay, so in general, you can write it as square root of your this times. Okay, you understand? Okay, Deepika?
Yeah.
Okay, now the next, these are the properties you will be using. U dot V is nothing but V dot U. So both the sides answer will be the same. How will you do? Just there is no negative sign there. So if you add and multiply, you are going to get the same answer. Okay. It's like a commutative property you can have. Then this is like an associative property. C dot U dot V is nothing but you are going to multiply a constant there. So nothing will affect there. Okay. Fine. Then U dot V plus W will be U dot V plus U dot W. Okay. And if you are going to multiply the given vector with the zero, the dot product becomes zero. Okay. You understand? Because see, for example, if I'm going to have U equal to 1, 2, 3. Okay. U I will have. This is zero. Whatever you do here, zero, zero, zero. When you multiply with this, you will get the zero as well. Okay. You got it? Yes, Deepika.
Yeah.
Similarly, as I've already told you, these kind of dot products where we will be using to find the value of a particular length or where your angle we need to find it out. So obviously, we need a formula for finding the angle. So let U and V be two vectors. Okay, they are having U and V. So definitely, the opposite direction would be U minus V. Okay, now. They are saying that then U dot V, dot product of U and V is nothing but absolute value of U times absolute value of V times cosine of theta. Okay. So how I'm going to do that? Let U and V be a pair of adjacent sides. Okay. Whose third side will be this one. Fine. So that's what they have drawn here. I'm going to use the cosine law. Have you studied your sine and cosine laws before? Yes, in trigonometry?
Yeah, in trigonometry, yes.
Yes. So they would have you would have had the sine law and cosine laws, right? Okay. So there, if I can say, the formula for that cosine law, if you are going to have, it would be nothing but, see, for example, it is b squared will be equal to a squared, okay? In general, I will write, not this one. See, usually, if I wanted to find a thing, your cosine law will be a squared will be equal to b squared plus c squared minus 2bc cosine of a. Okay? Using this one, I can either find this side or this angle. Okay? Fine, Deepika? Same thing we are going to use and find it here. Okay, so that is what I'm going to do using the cosine law here. It is absolute value of U minus B the whole squared. How can you write it as it is A plus B the whole squared type? Okay, so absolute value of U squared plus absolute value of B squared minus 2AB cosine of theta U equal to half. Okay, this is for triangles we are using. Okay, that's the difference. Okay, so now what will happen? It is U minus this you can write as it is U minus B the whole squared, right? So U minus B. Dot product of U minus V. Okay. Now it's just a dot product. So you have to do it for each and everything. Okay. Got it, Deepika? So this will become absolute value of u the whole squared is u dot u. Then this would be v dot v. Okay, and this I'm giving. As I told you, you have to start multiplying for the next step. U dot u minus u dot v minus v dot u my plus v dot. Okay, you understand? Then we are just keeping this as it is. Now, what is my aim? I have to find u dot v. Okay, so try to cancel all the other terms. Okay, so this side you will be left with negative 2 u dot v, because if you can see here v dot u, and this you can take it to the other side. Find the pickup. So you will be left with this term and this one. Okay, now u dot v will be nothing but this two, negative 2 and negative 2 gets cancelled. Okay, so if they are going to ask a formula to find the angle, you can use this one. Okay, so for solving or finding angle between two vectors, okay, your formula is nothing but u dot v is absolute value of u times absolute value of v multiplied by cosine of theta or cos theta. So if they are asking, directly they are asking, they are given u dot v is what u or v is given. Okay, they are asking you to find the angle, means you can say that cosine of theta is u dot v divided by absolute value of u times absolute value of v. Okay, so for example, they have given a fourth problem here. For the cosine of the angle between the vectors u and v, they have given to us. Okay, so cosine of theta is nothing but u dot v divided by absolute value of u times absolute value of v. What is the meaning of absolute value? It is square root of, this is a square plus b square plus c square. We are squaring it and adding it up. Okay, the numerator, you are just multiplying the first component with first plus, second component with second plus, third component with third. Okay, got it, Deepika?
Yeah.
Now just start simplifying this. This is square root of 14 to square root of 26. Okay, now 14 I can write it as 7 times 2, and 26 I can write it as 2 times 13. Okay, now the square root of 2 is common, just multiply and take it out. 2 is the cup. Okay, so your cosine inverse will be equal to square root of 13 over. If you want, you can use a calculator and find, you will get 47. Okay, understand, Deepika?
Yes.
Okay, they have taught you orthogonal vectors and normal vectors?
No.
No, right? Only this is there, right? Okay, dot products. Okay,
yeah, just, but it's there.
Yeah, 1 minute. Then I won't teach that. I will take the exercise. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So in the problems from 1 to 3 below, we have to calculate the dot product for this. Can you try this u dot v first? You are able to do, Deepika?
Yeah, much.
Okay. As this is a problems only we are doing, I'll stop the screen share. I mean,